sort of at sea. A lot of people up there watching. Watching from their balconies. Looking pretty close to the cabin next to me. There's my GoPro attached. So,
it's a little humid. It's kind of cool right now.
It seemed warmer earlier. There's the bottom ship. So I imagine there's people out there. Of course, the bridge is right below me. So if I pound my feet, I think it might annoy them. I don't know. So we're crossing underneath the bridge of the Atlantic, Atlantic Bridge. There are several of these harbor pilot boats come and go. They keep dropping people off down there and picking people up. Court lecturer said this was built by the French for $366 million, and I guess they just finished it. Still pretty far from locks, though, I think. You can see all the people out on the Monkey Island bridge deck. And of course, it's just jungle out there. Solid jungle. And then a big bridge. And the open sea. So a ship has entered the old canal. There's the first of the old locks right there. You can't really see anything. Even if I go way up here. And we're into the new locks. And there's a tugboat right down there. You can't see it, but they're tying on. We get towed through. And I don't mean like a frog. I mean towed. There's Janet's head. And there's my GoPro making a time lapse. Now he's going faster than us by a lot, and that ship is called the Denver. This is what it looks like on the bridge cam. I'm sitting on my bed, and that's the TV. And so if I were up there, that's what I'd see. Right there are the locks. First locks, I guess. Occasionally a guy announces stuff. You should know, we're on deck 15, which leads out to Monkey Island, the bridge deck. And it's just been an endless line of people. Most of them going out there still. Most of them not worrying about do not disturb signs, because it's not them getting disturbed. Notice. There are tugboats putting on a little show. It says Darien. Here comes another tugboat. Thank you. I don't know how many it takes to pull us through here. But the tugboats pull and push us through the locks, the canal. Of course, the big bridge is still just right there. And Denver is right there. And there's still a bunch of people on Monkey Island. I went up to the front. First log. You can see another ship ahead of us. And the gate closing. Wait, you see that gate closing?
Oh no, are you going New York? But
it's very slow. Right down here, just on the other side of that fence, you can see a crocodile laying there. I'm going to try to enlarge that for you later. Right there, now you got to look through the fence to see him, on the concrete there, right in the middle of the screen. Anyway, so we're like in there. Looks like we're in Crooked there, doesn't it? There's the bridge. Crocodile tour buses go in. People yelling. Whatever this box is here, it's vibrating. There's the black box, of course, which is orange, as everyone knows. So we are coming into it. And of course in these locks there's plenty of room on the sides. In the old locks there's just a foot or so, maybe inches. And those are the sliding doors there. I don't know if you can tell. Got the green on top. There's two of them. We're gonna slide those in behind us and fill this up with water. And then open the next ones and on through we go. So the gates are closing now. In the back of the ship, of course. Sean just took our pictures. Look at all the people. Oh, we could have gone way up there. So once they get all the way to the other side there, they'll fill this with water. To leave now. We've got a tugboat down below. Forward slightly. There's a guy on shore there taking our pictures. But you can see we're still advancing.
Position Locked doors act as bridges and cars drive across them once they're closed. So there must have been a lot of cars waiting because now 20 or 30 have gone in each direction. Zoom back out. That's the terrace pool. And that's the bridge of the Atlantic or whatever they're calling it. We're all the way up on deck 19 now. This is a little golf course here. And down on them. Can't see the numbers real well now, but we've gone up several meters.
So,
Janet says that side's more the sun. I honestly can't see the picture I'm taking.
It's at 24.
Because of the reflection. Okay, the back of the ship is there. We're up on, this would be 18, another part of 18. It just filled the chamber we're in. You can't really see anything from here. We're gonna open the gates in front, and we're going to advance through. There's the sanctuary. That costs money. I don't think very many people are using it these days on these cruises. I guess people are out here this morning, and they left a mess. So, it's a concrete wall they built. I guess those are water towers. And that's Janet. Back in our cabin, it's my GoPro. They've opened these set of sliding doors, and we're making our way forward out of this lock and into the next one. So there's signs there. That one says 700. That one says 600. On the dock there, that says 700 with an arrow pointing left and 700 with an arrow pointing right. And what that means is from that point, you got 700 feet in each direction. So that's the middle of the lock. See, this one says 750, 650 from door to door, I guess. They've thrown a rope out to the ship, or the ship threw a rope out to the guy on shore. I don't know what their plan is, but we are getting closer to the side. So I don't know if somebody's going to jump on or off or what exactly. But we're coming up to the second lock. Well, we're almost into the second lock, and then it's going to close and raise us up. I think they use that water to raise us up, but I'm not sure. Of course, the bridge is still right there. I'm not sure if you can tell, but the water's come up quite a bit. And That sound means they're about to open these gates in front of us so that we can pull into the next lot. And that should be the third and final of these lots. So not till they're going to open these doors here, these locks, and we're going to drive through. But it's almost to the brim now. So it raises 28 feet. Of course, that 700 marker is right there. So that's midship. We're a bit forward. Janet says, the plane. I mean, they're opening. And they are, if you can see that. Sliding back. Once they get all the way back, they'll pull forward. And then they'll fill that one up. It's a guy waving. So now we're going forward. We went down to deck 7. Get a better look at stuff. Pulling into the last of the
orbs here.
And that guy's loud. So these are the sliding doors. As you can see, they're hollow inside. And there's two of them. So once, and then there's some in front of us there. They're closed. And then beyond that is the lake. We're going to go past these, just like the other places. And then they're going to close them and fill this lock up with water. Well, actually, we're right between two locks now. That's the last lock, and that's the one we just came from. See that? And that's the one we're headed to. You can see the markers. There's the 1200. Which means 1400, if they had one, would be somewhere over there. That must be 1300 that we can't see. Let's move up. There's the gates. They're still closed. So they can fill this tank up. And we can rise up to the level of that lake. Those are the people that work. Although they mostly seem to stand around. People's heads here. But if you look up on that hill, it's like an observation deck and it's full of people. So we're gonna pull in here and fill this up and then go into that way. And then it's like 40 miles to the other side and the other locks that are gonna bring us back down. So here's the 700 marker again. So that's the middle of a lock we're passing. Of course, now we're at the front of the ship, so that's the very front right there.
You can see the water line.
Janet says, see the water line? And there's the rope they're going to throw to these guys. Well, now they're down here. So they can tie off. I don't mean there. I mean he's going to try to throw it to those guys. Getting ready, and there he goes. And they just barely caught it. So they'll tighten that up with the big rope. It's going to come out of the bottom there somewhere. You can see the tugboat more now. Look over there, you'll see the guy that's cleaning up this town. Guys. That's right. So here we are. sailing out of the last lock.
As we sail into Gatun Lake,
and that guy comes on.
So we're
sailing into Gatun Lake there.
Is Bauer, Colorado Island, home of the world famous Smithsonian Tropical Research.
So that's how close we are to the forest or the jungle as we pass through into Gatun Lake. Of course, you can see it opens up into a big lake, almost like an ocean. So we're in Gatun Lake. The locks are back that way. You can see the ships coming and going there, passing us, following us. We're of course driving on the right, so the ones passing us are over on the other side of the ship. And this is what it's like. It's just a bunch of little islands with trees on them. Of course, this was rivers before, you know, hundreds of feet below us. And these were the tops of hills. But they dammed it up for the canal, and now they're just islands. Way off in the distance, we could hear howler monkeys, I think. They were making quite a racket. They were really howling. So I don't know if those are houses or what. So we just turn to the left. We have a long way to go. The hills are getting higher though. Maybe the forest a little more dense. Still in Gatun Lake. Seems like we're going fast, but I guess we're not really. Not too many people on Monkey Island now though. In Gatun Lake still, but we're getting out of the wide area. Look at that reddish, orange, yellow, maybe. I think we're getting into the narrow part of this all. Up there. Where we've been. Occasionally, one of these zips by. So this old rusty stuff, and the old rusty stuff we saw before, is dredging equipment that's pretty much been abandoned. But it's not looking for gold, it's dredging up the channel here. We're back up on the front of the ship. More people are coming here all the time. Most people are trying to keep the shade. That's that guy's balcony, unfortunately. Although they've had this deck closed almost the whole time. But we're coming up to the bridge there. Ring Cooper. This is an area they had to blast out of the mountains. And this, in fact, is the Continental Divide right up here. Those two, what's left of the mountains. And then the Bridge of the Americas, spanning the canal here.
There is good viewing from here at the front, so the back.
That's our guy talking.
Right on the left-hand side.
So we are currently transversing the Continental Divide. As soon as we get on the other side of this little hill here, which they call a mountain, we'll be on the Pacific side. So, Atlantic side, where we came from. Pacific side. And they call that bridge the Centennial Bridge. Centennial. So if I called it something else, I was wrong. Like Bridge of the Americas. I guess that's further up, maybe. That's Centennial Bridge. We're going across under the Centennial Bridge there. We just came through the Continental Divide, so now we're on the Pacific side.
We are now approaching the second of three major bridges you'll be seeing today. This is called the Centennial Bridge.
Hear that?
Which is supplement the overflight bridge of the Americas. Actually, placed in the highway when it opened back in 2004. It became the only second permanent crossing of the canal. The contract to build the replacement bridge was awarded in 2002. An ambitious schedule of just 29 months was set for construction in order that the bridge could open on the 90th anniversary of the first ship during the transit, the Anton, back in 1914. The bridge is named for Panama Centennial, which occurred on the 3rd of November of 2003. The main span is 320 meters or 1,050 feet and clears the canal by 80 meters, which is 262 feet, allowing large vessels like ours and others to pass beneath it. So we're now passing beneath the famous Centennial Bridge, and sometimes those in cars like to throw candy bars down to those watching on the cruise ship upper decks.
He says people in the cars throw candy bars at us. Cucaracha tick. Something about that one being right on the shore and that one being in from the shore, that so they can widen us. Nonsense again. So here's the underside of concrete. We've reached the other locks. We're passing by a ship that's anchored here. And it's starting to rain pretty hard. And we've slowed way down. In fact, we nearly stopped there for a little while. Monkey Island cleared out though pretty well. But I don't know how well we're going to see the locks here when we go back down to the Pacific Ocean. You can hear it though, huh? Maybe you can even see it. Apparently it's raining hard enough for there to be water pouring off that ship. See that? Although it seems to be letting up now. Bridge has been using their windshield wipers. See them? Anyway, we're, like I said, almost at a standstill here, waiting for our turn in the locks. So we are clearing the first lock now. Of the three to get back to the Pacific. Here's where the gates close in. Those little notches. See that? Man, this has been slower than on the Atlantic side for some reason, or it seems slower. Maybe it's harder to drain the swamp than it is to fill it. Here's this thing now. Somebody's taking a picture of them. So I'm guessing that's like the control tower for it. But I'm not sure it needs one. There's ruins of something out there. See that? But so we're gonna enter the next lock. They'll close these gates behind us. And drain it again. And then one more and we're in the ocean, Pacific Ocean, that is. There's the control tower, or what I call the control tower. We are actually headed into the very last lock before we reach the Pacific Ocean. We're almost there. And we seem to be going faster this time than the other times. It's kind of weird, really. So look how fast we're going now. I'm sure we went slower before, but right there is the 850, 550 marker. So next will be 750, 650, or 800, 600, I'm sorry. But right over there is the 700, 700, which is the middle marker. Although we'll go past that because we're not in the middle of the ship. We're not midships. We are forward. I mean, there's the bridge right there. People down on the dock yelling. People on the bridge. People on the bridge. Of course, you can see the Bridge of the Americas up ahead there, right? Probably not too well from here, though. Anyway. So. Remember, the GoPro's here, doing a time lapse of the whole thing, the whole day, with a couple little, you know, battery changes. Of course, it's getting dark now. The sun's about to set. These people live out here. Slowing down. So that noise is the sound of the last gate opening. And the ship is actually moving backwards slightly for some reason. But I can see up ahead there that the last gate is open now. And so we're at Pacific Ocean level. We're also in for maybe a really lovely sunset. Well, we're finally moving ahead. Beeping just stopped. We're going to be passing the locks here in just a second, and we'll be in the Pacific Ocean. Although we'll be in some sort of harbor still for a while. A mile or so, I think. And just in time, because the sun has gone down. I mean, it's still plenty light out here. Of course, they got lights. It's all because of those guys. Clear the lock in just a moment. I think I'll stay on until we do it. People are still up on the bridge deck. Of course, people have come back out here too, because it's not raining anymore. Adios. Looks like people are starting to leave the bridge deck now. We've seen enough. this. I turn this enough. Oh, I gotta come back here. Oh. So part of that's the reflection in the glass here. Activity on the bridge there. And some activity above the bridge. So here's another one of those fire nozzles. Right there. So they can put a fire out on the ship, I suppose, pretty fast. I've seen them periodically along the way. Of course, this one's out of the lock, so I'm not sure. And there's this long wharf or pier or whatever. And then we'll cross into the bridge. So as we leave, we're getting really close to the side there. We were away from it, you see, there's a gap there, but now we're pulling back out now. It's like somebody wasn't paying attention. We almost hit the edge, the dock, it looked like. We're very close to it. Appears we're using our thrusters, which we haven't used the whole journey because we've been pulled and pushed by tugboats, but we must be going under our own power now. You can see the lock closing behind us there. That's what the beeping is. And there's another ship back there, see it? In the lock before. That's almost closed. The beacon will stop after it closes, and then it will fill with water so that guy can drive into it, and then empty water. Here's the end of the dock. So that's our Panama Canal transit. That's the canal back there. But we're finally crossing under that bridge. I think they call it the Bridge of the Americas. Probably can't really see it that well. Maybe you can see the taillights of the cars up there. The camera keeps going in and out of focus. So, we're about ready to go right under it. Panama Canal. Till next time.